And Nawawi said, yeah, that from this reply it can be inferred that when a scholar is asked about what he does not know, he declares that he does not know it without detracting from his rank. On the contrary, such an answer shows his God-fearing scrupulousness. My teacher, may Allah raise his rank, Sheikh Muhammad Ali Yaqubi, he said to me in one of the permissions, he wrote in there that he said, part of the permission given to anybody is that if you're asked and you know not, say, I don't know, for indeed it is half of knowledge. فَإِنَّهُ نِصْفُ الْعِلْمِ. And that's more important than anything. He said to us, if you have one iota of doubt, say, I don't know. He said, say, just say, I don't know. Even if you know, meaning, and there's that one, it's like, I'm pretty certain, check it. So check it and then give your answer. He said, because you will regret it. And that raises a person's rank. You see, now we have people, Allah musta'an, who have an answer to every question. They have entire television shows. They never say, I don't know. It's like, of course, we've got the answer for that, and we've got the answer for that. And the Bedouin came to Imam Malik and said, ya Imam, he had 40 questions. Every single question, Imam Malik said, la adri, I don't know. He answered about 7 or 8. He said, what am I to tell the people? He says, tell them, akhbirahum, qala Malik, la adri. Malik said, he doesn't know, what you want me to do? Make it up. You know, I just don't know. Now, and Malik was a man who memorized more than 1 million hadith. I'm not talking about with their Bukhari page number. I'm talking with the people in the chain, their life stories and the life stories of the people they narrate from. Memorized. And he just said, Allahu a'lam. I don't know. We'll see. Inshallah, we'll ask somebody more knowledgeable. Inshallah.